Karnataka, after Karnataka, this is Goa, and this is going to be Bihar also. How do you see and what do you have to say?
No, I think we are facing today a very major threat to democracy in this country and all the democratic values that we have cherished and lived by all these 70 years. Now, you yourself referred to the Supreme Court, the matter is in the Supreme Court. It is not a matter which should go to the Supreme Court. It's very bad for our democracy that political questions should be decided by courts of law. Political questions should be decided by political system of the country. And the political system would have been saved if the governor had not acted in the manner in which he has acted. He has clearly invited a party which does not have majority, and it will not have majority unless it breaks in violation of the anti-defection law. It breaks the existing parties which have representation in the Karnataka Assembly. So the governor has created a situation for horse trading in Karnataka. This is the first thing that he should have prevented. Instead of that, he has given full opportunity by swearing in Mr. Yedurappa and giving him 15 days time to do what he likes.
And by this, now this is going to be the Goa also. Now Congress is planning to move to the governor.
I don't care what Congress is doing. And let me tell you, we are sitting here under Rashtramanch, which is something that the movement for saving democracy that we had launched in January. The point is this, that Goa is a prime example of post-coal coalition. Because the BJP chief minister of Goa had lost, 7-8 ministers had lost their election. And even then, as the second largest party, the BJP formed a post-coal coalition and was allowed to form the government. The governor called the BJP leader, Mr. Parikar, to form the government, isn't it? By calling a minority BJP in Karnataka, the new rule which is being written in our parliamentary system of democracy that it will always be BJP which will be called. Whether they are in a minority, they are in a majority, whether it is a pre-poll alliance, whether it's a post-poll alliance, it has to be BJP by hook or by crook.
And a call has been taken in Bihar also. Now this is RJD also, who is also planning to move or meet governor tomorrow.
The RJD, Mr. Manoj Jha, will confirm when Nitish Kumar had broken away from the alliance and Tejaswi Yadav had claimed that he represented the largest single party in Bihar and he should be called. He was denied that opportunity. So you deny it in Bihar, you deny it in Goa, you deny it in Manipur and suddenly enforce it in Karnataka.
Thank you so much.